Hello and welcome to The Journey. Today we will be rewinding the hands of time and counting down the journey's best bits for 2014. So first up, we have Mr. R2G, also known as the grandpapa of hip life. Interviewing him was such a pleasure, and boy, did I laugh. What is his name? Reggie Rockstone. Here is our number five.
Strong, Samson, with a smartphone.
Let's go.
No, Delilah, fresh.
It's the same. This is Reggie Rockstone, your circle president, the grandpapa, microphone jatter, from your doctor, the hip-life originator, and I've been on a long journey. My sister, baby Nayoka.
Yeah. Let's talk about VVIP.
VVIP.
First and foremost, what is with the extra V? What does that stand for?
Extra V is when, ooh, that's my joint. Sorry. The extra V is when I stepped into the group.
You shocked a lot of people. I mean?
For me, it's really exciting.
But why did you decide to join the group? Did you sit down and think this through?
No,
audition?
It actually started off as a joke. It's when Palmzy, one of the original members, left the group, I put it on Twitter. I was just joking. So I'm like, yo, haha. Palmzy left the group. I've always wanted to be a member of VIP, whoopie whoop. And then the response that came was like, yeah, go ahead, man, join them, you know. And so I applied for the job. And
you applied?
Yeah.
The godfather of hip life had to apply to be in a group.
I'm the one that called them up. Prodigal was in New York, and Lazy was here. It's now Zeal, his name was Lazy at the time. And I said, look, you're missing one member, and the one thing you know that grandpa can do is rap. I mean, that's like, that's...
No doubt.
I got a few bars left.
So what was the selection process like? Were there loads of applicants? Did you have to send them a video? What happened?
Nah, man, that's just a phone call. Grandpa, you know, rock, I'm down. I'm trying to, you know, do something different, creative.
Next up, this Afro hip hop duo go way back from the streets of Ashanman to establishing Uptown Energy. The ghetto youth absolutely love them. Who do we have? It's Yapono and Sugar Kwame, number four.
I want to ask you about your relationship with Sarkodie. Wait, what exactly happened? Are you guys friends? Are you no longer friends?
I think this is the first time I'm talking about Sarkodie on video. We are friends. We just recorded a new track
called
Talk of GH, and people are taking it personal. You know, but ever since Dr. Duncan did the signing with him and I went back to school, everything turned different. His life turned different because his music, he was the platform, and then his music was trending and moving. But what I was working on was how to also get myself together and then push my music.
You know when Professor Duncan Williams signed Sarkodie, did he inform you?
No, he didn't inform me. It looked like everything that was going on between them was, I don't know, the right informal, like there wasn't any paperwork. I don't know if there was, but like they had a relationship. We all had a relationship. That's the same way Dr. Duncan would treat me if he's managing me.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Did you expect somebody to tell you?
Yeah, no, he mentioned it in his music, Dan Cruz Entertainment, and I knew everything is good, you understand? So, and from that time, Dr. Duncan never abandoned us. He also makes sure whenever I'm going on stage, he could introduce me, or he calls and check up on us, or sometimes he takes us out. But I think that wasn't the thing we wanted. We all wanted for him to sign us on. And then we move, but nothing happened.
Are you guys dating at the moment?
I was.
Why do you have to think about it?
Yes, because these type of questions are very humdrum.
So my next guest goes by the name Mr. Oreo. I was hoping that during the interview he would teach me how to wind my waist. But I guess I'm going to have to learn how to do that by myself. Next up, I'm coming up step by step.
With the kind of body you have, why do you tease women? When you're performing, you know, like at Cocoa Bar, you ripped off your top, and women were passing out all over the place. You saw them, you saw the kind of response they gave you.
I don't tease them, man. I sweat. When you're jumping up, and now it's very hot, and then you have like a lot of beautiful girls there. The room is even hotter, so you have to take your shirt off and just get
like
some air.
Right?
Trust me, man. If Rick Ross can, why can't
I? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You've worked hard for your body.
Thanks. I think next time we need like a very controversial question.
You know, I had a controversial question, but I've actually been warned not to ask.
Yeah. But this one is quite safe, man. But I'm glad I passed
so
it.
So I should ask you the question that I wanted.
Nah, I know where you're going.
No.
Everybody just.
Do you don't know what the question was? This is the thing.
So this has on to my side. Have me doing moves I never even knew I had in me. I would demonstrate, but I've forgotten most of them already. We can't help but smile watching him do what he absolutely loves, and that's dancing and entertaining. Number two, Sammy T.
So I would like to introduce you to my guest. His name is Sammy.
You're right, how you doing?
I'm well, thank you. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Fantastic. Do you know why I call you the Azonto Master, Sammy? Have you seen how you move?
Yep.
You move like a dream. Like seriously, I wish I had your legs and feet and hand movements. If I could do that, I'd be finished. That would be it.
I can see it to you.
Thank you, Sammy.
That shouldn't be a problem.
So I can't let you go without asking you to show me a few moves. You must. I have to remember this day forever.
Yeah, I can do that for you. And I only do that just because of you.
Thank you so much. So I'm going to get up, shake a leg a little bit. Nothing too tricky. I'm not that flexible.
No, I'm not going to make it. So I'm just going to.
Nothing too tricky. So let me get up and get into my dancing position.
First move now?
Yes, what's the first move? So I should turn sideways.
Yeah? Whoa!
Okay.
That was the first time.
No, no,
are you ready? So we're going to do that four times.
Okay.
Yeah? Let's go. Singing on the whole Ghana, dancehall king on the whole Ghana. The girl dem a lean on the whole Ghana. Shakam movement team on the whole Ghana. Money makers team on the whole Ghana.
So me say tick tock, bust me a bass. Think set, last come a last. Long time, nobody cross. We still got the titles, how we not worry. Every pretty girl shake body, cause the tune just a eat and we never copy. Shakam movement, champagne popping. SM, no girl dem call it, so we not stop. Still got the mob, me say sick me a sick and knock me a knock. Any man try, dem.
It has been an exceptional year for our last guest. He took the world by storm with the Azonto song, and his humility and talent have kept him in the charts and on our TV screens. Mr. Fizo DG, the journey seems number one.
She keep you the really share. I see how you're moving there. You better just stay in line. All I wanna do is just make you mine. You make my heart beat like playing grime. Now you wanna leave and say goodbye. African lady, you know say you got me crazy. I can't let you do me shady. The things that you do don't fit me. London baby, you know say you got me crazy. I can't let you do me shady. The things that you do don't fit me.
So that was the countdown for the journey's best bits in 2014.
We hope that, God willing, next year you'll be joining us for some more inspiring and fun filled interviews. We want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for your support thus far. It's been great and we appreciate it. From all of us at The Journey, a prosperous, gainful, and enjoyable new year.
Tried to dub me unworthy, but I can't dig it. I ain't getting my hands dirty. There's a science to the way you gotta play the game first. Knowledge age grows, so my mind's never first. They're trying to throw acid on my name, it ain't mercury. I don't react to that corrosive attitude, it can't hurt me. It's been a long road, but now I'm all in my lane. With a heavy ambition that's holding its own weight. Immovable objects, I'm pushing my own ways. Running my own race, hunting my own prey. Cause there ain't a soul on this earth to do it for me. I set itself soon in my crew.